Keyboy wanted to talk to us, but no one wanted to listen. And it made him really, really sad. He looked everywhere for someone who would listen. He even tried magic tricks to get their attention. Keyboy Blue had a frown for his whole life. And one night, he told me that the sky will fall.
Tsunamis of the Pacific washed away most of California and Oregon. The unexpected catastrophe has shaken the entire world. The national death toll, still unknown. The unidentified anomalous artifact, measuring just about the size of Shea Stadium, which astrologists are no longer classifying as an asteroid, was detected by the Virgin Atlantic moon base just hours before breaching Earth's atmosphere, giving international authorities minimal time to prevent or contain the devastation. News breaking this morning that NASA has lost contact with the submersive team sent into the ocean depths to investigate the artifact that fell from the sky and caused the catastrophic event. We will keep you updated as soon as NASA releases a statement on the communication breakdown. Meanwhile, off the coast of the Nepali island, a second perimeter, Zone 2, has been constructed around a sandbank where a fragment of the artifact is reported to have been embedded. We have received unofficial, unsubstantiated claims that the object is cylindrical in shape and emits a high degree of radiation, which has enabled IMCS officials to track its location. The president addresses heads of state at an emergency NATO summit held in New York City tomorrow night. The council will be convening with specialists from a wide variety of fields, including theoretical physicists, cosmologists, as well as two professors from the Princeton School of Engineering and Applied Science. On the source and nature of the artifact. Whether we are faced with the greatest natural disaster since the dawn of the Ice Age, or an external intelligent threat. This is Dave Conan, reporting live for Channel 5 News.
You hungry? Mm-mm. Do you want me to switch this off?
Okay.
Yeah, all right. Jerry and the kids are a bit shook up. Just a couple punks this time. You know, we should go down there tonight. Divide up some portions for them. Huh?
Hey! Knock it off.
I think we should double the watch. With the news back, things are gonna get bad fast.
Yeah, that's a good idea. If you think things are bad now, wait till people are willing to kill for what we got.
National Guard.
As of now, no one can explain how the artifact worked to universally evade our satellite grid.
Searched everywhere for a voice to be heard, inside the Giggle Mountains with the talking spirits who laughed at him, in the loud forest where the trees blew him away, and the cranky cactuses who were mean to him. He searched everywhere for a voice. Just when he was about to give up, he cried out to the sky and was struck by a red and yellow light. He said, "Ouch," and then he said, "I can talk."
What did he do with his voice? Sweetheart, what's wrong? I got it.
Hey,
Come here. Come here. Up you go.
Things have been pretty scary lately, huh? Yeah. That's why I've been outside in the bunker so much. To prepare for the worst. For our safety. Okay? And I promise you, no matter what, we will always be together. Okay?
All right.
Now, come on. I think we should clean up this mess for Mommy. Yeah?
Let's go.
Stars live in space. See, Bootsy? Daddy says this one was there for all of us. But do you want to know who else lives in space? The angels. The milk spurt.
Mom?
Mom.
Did you feed Bootsy?
Huh? Mommy, you forgot to feed Bootsy.
Yeah.
Hi, Bootsy. Miss me? Looks like I'm moving in with you, okay?
To lead us to his light. No longer a warning, but a beacon. That light? They call it the light you see at the end. But the truth is, we also see it at the beginning. I was comfortable, complacent, living in perfect homeostasis, living in perfect condition. Then, there was a rift. I was forced out of the environment in which I was accustomed. I was forced to evolve, to cry, to breathe, to endure chaos, pain, all in the name of creation. I thought I was dying. And I was actually being born.
Thank you. Thank you.